And when there cometh unto them a messenger from Allah, confirming that which they possess, a party of those who have received the scripture fling the scripture of Allah behind their backs as if they knew not, and follow that which the devils falsely related against the kingdom of Solomon. Solomon disbelieved not, but the devils disbelieved, teaching mankind magic, and that which was revealed to the two angels in Babel, Harut and Marut. Nor did they, the two angels, teach it to anyone till they had said, "We are only a temptation, therefore disbelieve not in the guidance of Allah." And from these two angels people learn that by which they cause division between man and wife, but they injure thereby no one save by Allah's leave. And they learn that which harmeth them and profiteth them not. And surely they do know that he who trafficketh therein will have no happy portion in the hereafter. And surely evil is the price for which they sell their souls, if they but knew. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, Alif Lam Mim. This is the scripture whereof there's no doubt, a guidance unto those who ward off evil, who believe in the unseen and establish worship, and spend of that we have bestowed upon them, and who believe in that which is revealed unto thee, Muhammad, and that which was revealed before thee, and are certain of the hereafter. These depend on guidance from their Lord. These are the successful.
Every closed door lies a mystery. For the Freemasons, the hidden history begins inside a sacred temple, 1,000 years before Christ, with the shadowy figure at the heart of Freemasonry, Hiram Abiff, also known as the Widow's Son.
According to the Freemasons, the Widow's Son of Hiram Abiff is the master builder of King Solomon's Temple.
The temple will house the stone tablets inscribed with the Ten Commandments and the holy presence of God himself. According to Freemason legend, Israel's King Solomon has received the design directly from God. Hiram, too, knows the secrets of the divine plan.
In the story, Hiram Abiff is accosted by three junior workers who are jealous of the fact that they have not been given all the secrets of masonry, and they try to extort them from Hiram Abiff.
The workers believe that a single secret code word will give them Hiram's knowledge of God's divine plan, and with it, magical powers. So the three workers lie in wait at the temple's three doors. As Hiram approaches the east door, the first man stops him and demands the secret. Hiram replies that when the temple is finished, he will be told the secret word.
The word is given in recognition of accomplishment. When a mason has proved himself as an apprentice and as an expert craftsman, he's then recognized by being given the word of a master mason.
Rebuked, the man slashes at Hiram's throat with a sharpened stone. Hiram escapes, but at the south door, the second man demands the secret. Again, the wounded Hiram refuses and is struck with a mason square. Hiram staggers to the west door. Again, the demand. Again, he refuses and is finally dealt the death blow. As he dies, he cries, "Who will help the widow's son?" The phrase will become the Freemason's universal cry for help from brother Masons. Hiram Abiff's refusal to give up his secret knowledge to the undeserving makes him the greatest of Freemason heroes. What you're seeing is a recreation of the initiation rite of a master mason. The exact contents of the ceremony remain a secret, but the History Channel was able to create this scene with the help of present and former Freemasons.
When I joined, the rituals were just about as crazy as I thought they would be. I asked everybody what they meant, and the answer was, "Well, you'll find out, don't worry." And over the next 2-3 years, it became evident they hadn't a clue. Nobody knows what those rituals are about. So it started me in my quest to try and understand them further.
To have my body cut in two, my bowels removed and burned.
The candidate swears a solemn oath never to reveal what transpires in this room on pain of death. Then, playing the role of Hiram, he is struck with three ritualized blows and simulates death. Two times, other Masons try to revive him, but in vain. The third time, they succeed, and the candidate rises. Reborn as a Master Mason.